Hello and welcome, I'm Divya and you are watching Special Report. Today we are discussing a very critical issue, the concept of Waqf, its misuse and reforms proposed by the Modi government. It's very important to understand what is Waqf. Now Waqf is an Islamic endowment meant for religious or charitable purposes aimed at serving public welfare. However, over the years, it has been caught up in mismanagement and disputes over land ownership. Now, despite being intended for social good, the misuse of Waqf properties has created legal battles and raised very serious concerns about transparency. Now, Waqf properties, which are supposed to be for charitable purposes, are being leased for commercial profit, completely defeating the original purpose. Now, many Waqf lands are now being used for private businesses, turning charity into profit-making ventures. Now, this has sparked an outrage, particularly among Hindu groups who feel that this undermines the whole concept of Waqf. In several cases, people found their private properties being wrongfully registered as Waqf, leading to legal fights and growing demands for reform. So now let us talk about Modi government's proposed Waqf Amendment Bill. Now, this bill aims to bring transparency, prevent the misuse of Waqf properties and introduce stricter regulations. Now, one of the key reforms is the mandatory verification of Waqf claims, ensuring that no false claims are being made without proper checks. Now, the bill also seeks to curb the commercial use of Waqf properties, ensuring they are used for the right purposes. However, this bill has faced opposition, especially from Congress. Now, Congress has been heavily criticized for converting prime evacuee properties into Waqf for vote bank politics. Now, many accuse the party of using land policies to appease minority communities, ignoring the rights of the larger population. But the Modi government's reforms aim to put an end to these appeasement tactics and restore fairness and justice in land management. Now, another issue with the current Waqf system is its exclusionary nature. Women, Bohras and Aga Khanis are not allowed decision-making roles in the Waqf boards. Now, this lack of inclusivity has raised questions about the fairness within the Waqf system itself. Now, there's a strong need for reforms to ensure that all the stakeholders, including the underrepresented groups, have a voice in the Waqf decision-making process. Now, public support for the Waqf Amendment Bill has been overwhelming. Hindu organizations and citizens have sent lakhs of emails to the government urging them to move forward with these reforms. Now, these emails are a very clear sign that the public demands accountability and transparency in Waqf management. Now, the Modi government has received widespread support, showing that people are eager for these much-needed changes. In conclusion, the Waqf debate highlights deeper political and religious tensions in the country, and the need for reform is undeniable. The BJP's Waqf Amendment Bill is a bold step towards curbing misuse, safeguarding public interest, and ensuring transparency. Now, despite opposition, the reforms promise to bring fairness, justice, and cultural integrity to this very critical issue. That's all for today's special report. I'm Divya Sharma and we'll see you again in our next episode of One India Explains. Thank you.